that as an FPL asset. You need that guy to have that swag, that pride, right? I love
that's what Salah's all about, right? Like, exactly.
Right.
Anyway, moving on.
Speaking of Salah, that's a good segue into Salah's stats now. Let's talk about... This is pretty much, I think, the big topic this week. What do we do about one of the best FPL assets of the last three seasons? I
think
feels
we discussed
weird.
It.
It feels weird to even be sitting here discussing this. Let's talk about selling Salah.
It's what everyone wants to hear.
For use of. We've been in this boat a lot of times in the previous season, sometimes successfully, sometimes unsuccessfully. Let's mention that. But, you know, for you to consider this, it's a first, which is why I was like, wow, Zoff is thinking about maybe selling Salah.
I told you this last week also, right? That if you have to sell someone for Sterling, you should sell Salah rather than Bruno.
Yeah, agree. But that said, I thought in open play, Salah had more to offer. Just the penalty that Bruno got.
Fulham game is a bit hard to judge just because of the other players they played around him, right? It was such a weakened lineup. So, can't read too much into the Fulham game per se. But let's have a look at his numbers over here now. These are his stats for the last six matches. He is ranked, I think, around 8th for shots in the box. And I was having a look. From the first six matches of the season, he was averaging 4 shots in the box per match. Now, he is averaging close to what? Less than 2. The drop-off is right. I think, Bakar, you had mentioned something about his big chances, right? And I noticed this also, and he's still getting big chances.
Exactly. That's what I was going to say. The short volume has kind of dropped, but and so have the penalty area touches, but the big chances are still there. So his expected data is decent.
You sell him for somebody who's beating him on expected data and has an extra game in 29. I think that's the move that people are looking at, though. You know, I mean, people are looking of selling Salah. I think they've got Son, Bale, and Oba on the radar. At the moment. So
and we'll talk about those numbers. We'll talk about those numbers in the next two sections. I've got them up here. Let's look at Salah.
And while we're on the Salah topic, I know Azoff will never speak about this himself, but Azoff actually did a piece on Fantasy Football Scout on whether or not to sell Salah, and he covered it in depth, and I thought he covered all angles to it. So anyone who's looking whether or not to sell or keep Salah should definitely go and give that a read. That's a fantastic, fantastically written article by Azoff.
Thank you for the plug.
I echo Bakar's thoughts.
Thank you. So these are Salah's stats. Let's have a look now at Liverpool's attacking numbers also, right? I think this is also relevant. Now, Liverpool have scored only 4 goals in their last 6 matches. They've landed only... Now, in terms of shot volume, right? In terms of shots in the box, they're 5th, which is not bad. But what they're really falling short is in shots on target. Only 25 shots, and I think that's where they're ranked 8th. So they're not getting the shots off. I think it's the shots which they are getting on target, they're not really beating the keeper either. So it really looks like a crisis of confidence, swag, whatever you call it. And as someone as a Chelsea fan, right, I experienced this under Mourinho the season after we won the title. When things go wrong, everything seems to go wrong. Everything goes against you.
I just wanted to, at this point, I think, plug our friend AK's little thread that he did on Liverpool as well. And some interesting numbers that actually, which are quite relevant that I want to read out. And this is Liverpool attacks performance between game week 1 to 18 and game week 19 to 27. The shots in the box have gone down from 10-odd to 9-odd. Their big chances have gone down from 3 to 2.09. The shots on target have gone down from 5.76 to 4.27. The biggest difference is their goal conversion rate, which has gone down from 14% to 6%. That's less than half. There's about a 60% difference there in the goal conversion rate. So you were on point when you mentioned that the underlyings are not gone down that much. It's the goal conversion rate. So there's a little bit of a confidence issue or something of that sort happening there.
Do you see them coming out of it, though?
I do. I trust the quality of the players. I trust the manager. I think he's a good manager. I think the players are good. I think they'll come out of it. And I think the fixtures will help them. I quite like the fixtures that Liverpool have after the international break. And I think they'll come out of it.
I mean,
yeah, I was going to come to that. The run from game week 30 onwards is actually, it's very favorable.
I've got that up here. 1 second. I'll just load that.
Villa, Leeds, Newcastle, Southampton, West Brom. It's a great run.
One thing though, Bakar, as often we were having a chat about this, is the argument that people have for selling Salah at the moment, as you have somebody who's posting similar underlying numbers at 6 million, 6.5 million, whatever Jota's price is. And that's a factor to consider as well. You know, where you want a piece of the Liverpool attack, yeah, Jota is not the same as Mo Salah, but their underlying numbers and his performance has been good. So that's one of the things that people have in mind when they're selling a Salah at the moment. And I think
you can double up on Liverpool if they hit form and then you can captain Salah. I think that Salah is a more dependable captaincy option than Jota.
Yeah, fair enough. The point is Salah more dependable captaincy app option than a Kane at the moment or Oba at the moment, which people are looking at to captain? You know, people are not convinced about captaining a Liverpool attacker at the moment, which is fair.
Yeah, we will come to that when we discuss captaincy for the week.
I'm just having a look at the fixtures. I don't think the fixtures, for example, look at the home games, right, are any more easier than what we already played. So he's got Villa at home, Newcastle at home, Southampton at home, and Palace at home. These aren't necessarily like easier or harder than the game they've had against Burnley, Brighton, Fulham.
I think they're easier. I think they're easier. I think these are much more obliging defenses compared to what he's played off late. I think the fixtures great form, and I think Salah will come back.
I saw this joke on Twitter that we captained Salah against Leeds in game week 1. Game week 32, we might captain Bamford against Liverpool.
Yeah, that's actually worth discussing in the sense how open was Liverpool's defense. And MOTD and Shearer covered it really well, I thought. The problem is that Klopp is persisting with a high line at the moment, and they're just not pressing up front. Which is why it's so easy to ping balls behind their defense, which is a new young defense at the moment. So the defense is there for the taking. And as long as this form continues, it's also worthwhile mentioning that you don't bench your defenders against Liverpool until they find their form at the moment.
Right. Because I think Klopp has shown a little bit of adaptability. And I posted this on Twitter and I got not as much hate as I expected, to be honest, for it. In the terms of that, like, you know, he's not really adapted his tactics in terms of the high line. Maybe, like, you know, with the personnel he has, maybe he needs to be a little bit more flexible in his approach, change the system, change the formation, but he's been quite rigid.
Are any of us selling Salah?
Not this week, maybe in 29. If Arsenal go out of the Europa League, I'm definitely getting Oba in for Salah in 29.
Bakar?
I'm not selling this week.
Yeah, I'm not selling either at the moment. All right. Because also, none of us have a wild card remaining. Getting him back, selling him and then getting him back is 8 points at the moment. And I'm pretty sure I want him back in 32. So that's just something I'm keeping in mind.
Right. Cool. So let's have a look now at Spurs first.